Hey there, it is Tom Sawyer with another video on answering your questions. So, what do you want to know about guitar building? I think is what I've been calling this show so far, so let's go with that. And the next question comes from Robert Sparkman. Now, first things first, I have to say hi to Robert. Thank you for being a part of this channel so much and actually giving good comments and good critique and asking questions. I love it. It's so great. And keep it coming, dude. And the question he asked was, what are your thoughts on the number of woods used in a single build? Unless you intend to build a rainbow, I wouldn't use a bunch of different types on the body, but like multi-laminate necks, knobs, and other furniture in different contrasting woods are cool. I suspect I like more variation than most, maybe not too much. Now, there is actually a rule of thumb on the different woods that you would use on a guitar. Very basically put, there is usually your body wood, your top wood, your neck wood, and your fretboard wood. Now that's four. I would maybe say five, so that gives you the chance of using two woods for your neck. Nowadays though, that has changed drastically. I would still probably only use body wood, top wood, fretboard wood as the constants of three. But then with the introduction of multi-laminate necks becoming more and more of the mainstream, you can have three different woods in that neck already, so that adds up to six. Whether or not all those things work together is something that is pretty much up to taste. I wouldn't do too many crazy woods on the front side or the back side, because if you have a very, very gorgeous top, and then you put an even similarly ridiculous fretboard wood, and let's say you have a headstock veneer, it might very quickly become too much. But then if you have a very plain looking back and a very plain looking neck, sure, some people don't mind at all, but then it might all look a little bit too bland. If you like the minimal thing, sure, that works too. But I would say a good balance of everything is nice. So if you have a very good looking fretboard wood, you don't necessarily have to make everything else match that. Kind of depends on what you want your main thing to be. If you want the eye immediately to look at, or your crazy inlays, then your top doesn't need to be over the top. Excuse the pun. To me, it's all about personal preference, quite honestly. If you want to go crazy and have different types of wood, by all means, go for it. But I think what makes a good looking guitar is basically having one, maybe two points of focus that then contrast with the rest. If everything is a solid over the top, let's say you have a burl body with a super flame top that has like a burst, your fretboard is made out of three different types of wood and crazy inlays, and headstock plate that has like the same sort of thing, and then a nine part multi-laminate neck, it very quickly becomes too much for the eye to kind of take in. You have way too many details to kind of focus on. It can be a very impressive, you know, feat of skill or show of skill that it has been made, but it can become very ostentatious very quickly. Just a few, sprinkle in a few really impressive details, and that goes a hell of a lot longer way to show off skill, because you're able to have those contrasts between minimal and efficient use of detail. I feel like I'm kind of blabbering here, so I think, I hope I answered that question. It's also a matter of how you want to look at things. Do you want to look at things on the way of number of woods used aesthetically, or number of woods used tonally? Now I'm using that very, very broadly here, because is one of those things that, yes, I am going to make a video on, but it will trigger the hell out of a lot of people. But that is not the topic that we're covering today. I've blabbered on way too much. I have a feeling that I've gone on 13 different tangents in these few minutes that I've done this, so I'm gonna stop here, and I'll see you guys for another question some other time. Thank you, Robert, for this great question. See you again soon. Hopefully you have something else coming.